called Chamber in the
Extraordinary
Chambers in the Courts of Cambodia, and I'd like now to read the internal regulations of the Supreme Court Chamber. The internal regulations aims to govern the courtroom on public hearing day. In order to ensure the public order, security, and the effective functioning of the courtroom during the public hearing day, the President of the Supreme Court Chamber has established the following internal regulations regarding the appeal hearings in case 002/01 as follows. 1. All persons who wish to attend the hearing shall be present in the courtroom, the extraordinary chambers in the courts of Cambodia, by 8:30 a.m. in the morning and 1:30 p.m. in the afternoon.
2.
Participants and persons in the public gallery, except
the monks,
shall stand when the graphier announces stand and sit when the president of the Supreme Court Chamber announces sit down.
3.
Participants shall maintain dignified and proper behavior in the courtroom at all times. Participants shall wear appropriate clothing. Their clothing may not display slogans, indicate their support for a party of the proceedings, or be otherwise offensive in any way. Banners and posters will not be permitted in the courtroom. 4. All cameras, camcorders, tape recorders, and loudspeakers are prohibited in the courtroom, except as approved by the President of the Supreme Court Chamber.
5.
Smoking or bringing food or drinks inside the courtroom is prohibited.
6.
All weapons, explosives, ammunition, and inflammable substances are prohibited inside the courtroom, except for those carried by the ECCC's authorized security guards.
7.
The use of cell phones is strictly prohibited. Phone cameras and phone audio recordings are also prohibited, except as approved by the President of the Supreme Court Chamber.
8.
All persons are prohibited from changing seats or walking freely inside the courtroom.
9.
All persons are prohibited from clapping, cheering, shouting, or making loud noises that might disrupt the hearing.
10.
Permission must be granted by an ECCC authorized security guard in order to enter or exit the courtroom.
11. Sortir ou rentrer du prétoire. 11.
Children under 16 years of age are prohibited from entering the courtroom. Persons between 16 and 18 years of age may enter the courtroom if they are accompanied by a parent or legal guardian, unless they are attending the public hearing as civil parties or witnesses.
12.
Pursuant to the internal rules of the ECCC and the applicable laws of the Kingdom of Cambodia, the President of the Supreme Court Chamber may take preventative measures or direct action against any person who breaches these internal regulations made in Phnom Penh, 13 November 2015, President of the Supreme Court Chamber,
Kung Sri.
Thank you.
Veuillez vous lever.
Please be seated.
Président, venez vous asseoir.
President, in the name of the United Nations and the name of the Cambodian people, the Supreme Court Chamber in the Extraordinary Chambers in the Courts of Cambodia opens its hearing to hear the appeal against the judgment dated 7 August 2014 of the Trial Chamber of the ECCC in case file 002/19 September 2007 with the co-accused Nguyen Chi and Kyo Sampon. The bench is composed of the following judges. I, Kung Srim, the President, Judge Chandra Nihal Jasinghe, Judge Sam Sarivut, Judge Agnieszka Knobiska Milad, Judge Mongmoni Charya, Judge Florence Nepet Mumba, and Judge Ya Naren. The graphies are the following: Mr. Walker Malich, Mr. CMO, Mr. Sila Pailan, Mr. Paulo Lomba, and Mr. Pontoon. And Mr. CMO, are the parties all present?
CMO, veuillez faire état des parties présentes à l'audience ce jour. Sont-elles toutes là?
Greffier. Mr. President, the parties to discuss are present, except the International Council for Nguyen Chi, that is, Council Victor Kopre is absent. Thank you.
President,
National Council for the Defense of Nguyen Chi, could you inform the Chamber the reason for the absence of your International Council for Nguyen Chi?
De l'absence du Conseil international de Nguyen Chi?
Sonarun, good morning, Mr. President. Good morning,
bonjour,
Your
Monsieur
Honors.
Le Président. Madame, Messieurs les Juges, bonjour.
My client, Mr. Nguyen Chi,
mon client, Nguyen Chi,
would like to seek your permission to make a statement which lasts for about 20 minutes.
Une déclaration qui va durer à peu près une vingtaine de minutes.
His statement
Sa déclaration
will indicate the reasons
indiquera
for the absence of his International Council for the Defense.
À l'origine de l'absence du Conseil international de sa défense.
President, in International Co-Prosecutor, please be seated. Allow me to follow with our scheduling.
De suivre le programme qui
and
nous a, qui a été établi.
The National Council for Nunchi, is it your statement that the absence of the International Council is per instruction of his client, that is the accuser Nunchi? Am I correct? If that is the case, we still follow with the proceedings for the appeal hearing.
Nous pouvons continuer de suivre le programme des audiences en appel.
Per procedures, that is pursuant to Internal Rule 22.1 of the ECCC Internal Rule, despite the absence of the International Council, the National Council for the Defense cannot proceed to defend your client. Yes, I can follow the proceedings.
Oui, je. Mais c'est le cas.
Bah. Chẳng bà xôm chơi lục cứ cho.
President, thank you, Council. You may be seated.
Président, merci. Veuillez vous asseoir.
The Chamber would like to inform the parties that I will first start the opening of the appeal proceedings.
Les procédures en appel.
And I notice that the International Co-Prosecutor wants to take a stand before I proceed with the opening. You may take the floor.
Good morning, Mr. President, Your Honors. What I was going to suggest is the question, Mr. President, that you asked. I think it's important to clarify that the absence of the International Co-Counsel for Nunchia is with his consent. I'm not sure that the record is clear from what was translated about that. All I heard on the record was Mr. Sonnerun say that he could follow the proceedings. But if, please, I hope Defense Counsel, National Counsel will correct me if I'm wrong, but are we correct then in all of us taking his answer to mean that Nunchia consents to the absence of his international co-counsel.
De son conseil international.
President,
regarding this matter, and as stated by the National Defense Council for Nunchi, the accused Nunchi himself will make a statement.
Nunchia lui-même va prononcer une déclaration.
And for that, the chamber will give the floor to Nunchi to make his statement after my opening statement of the appeal proceedings.
J'aurais prononcé mon allocution d'ouverture des appels en audience.
Ngày nay ông chung nung chung rea tola ka kumpul baek kai pi phiat sa ding daol je leuk dambong neu leu
bandang sat. Today is the first day of the appeal hearing of the appeals brought by Nunchi and Kier Sampon against the judgment of the trial chamber of 7 August 2014. And the co-prosecutor's appeal regarding the applicability of the notion of joint criminal enterprise in its extended form. The chamber has received extensive written submissions in which the parties have set out their arguments in support of their respective appeals and their responses thereto. The Chamber has carefully studied and analyzed all these submissions in preparation for this hearing. It is not the purpose of the appeal hearing simply to rehearse the written submissions. Rather, it is an opportunity for the parties to highlight the most important aspects of their appeal and, in particular, to reply to arguments contained in the responses to the appeal briefs. Furthermore, I recall that in July of this year, the Chamber held a hearing to hear three additional witnesses on appeal. Moreover, the Chamber admitted eight additional documents into evidence. The appeal hearing that commences today is an opportunity for the parties to make submissions in relation to the additional evidence admitted on appeal by this Chamber, including the testimony of those three witnesses. It must be underlined that, as reflected in Internal Rule 109.6, the appeal hearing is not a mechanism for parties to raise matters of fact or law that were not previously set out in their submissions on appeal. I would like to invite the parties to keep this in mind when making submissions before the Chamber. The appeal hearing also provides the judges of the Chamber with an opportunity to ask parties for clarification of their submissions and to address questions that, in the view of the Chamber, are conducive to the determination of the appeal. Some of the questions were communicated to the parties on 5 November, together with the final timetable for the appeal hearing. Nevertheless, the judges of the Chamber may ask additional questions throughout the appeal hearing. In each session, there is time reserved for questions by the Chamber. The judges may also ask questions at any time in response to the submissions of the parties. In order to ensure an efficient use of time, the Chamber has decided to split up the appeal hearing into 6 thematic sessions, grouping the various grounds of appeal. The first 5 sessions concern the appeals brought by Nunji and Kyu Sampon. The appellants have submitted several hundred arguments in support of their respective appeals, alleging factual, legal, and procedural errors. The Chamber has attempted to group them to make it easier for the public to follow the appeal hearing. In an annex to the initial scheduling order for the appeal hearing, the Chamber indicated which grounds of appeal and paragraphs from the appeal briefs should be discussed in the respective sessions. I should highlight that sometimes this categorization was not easy to make, and some grounds of appeal could fall into more than one of the sessions. The first session, which is to start immediately after this introduction, concerns the grounds of appeal, alleging violations of the accused fair trial rights, as well as the issue of whether the ECCC's internal rules are unconstitutional and illegal. The second session concerns the grounds of appeal related to the trial chamber's overall approach to the evidence. This session is scheduled to commence the day after lunch. At the end of the day, time is reserved for the Supreme Court Chamber's questions on the subjects covered during today's sessions. Tomorrow morning, we will start with a session dedicated to the grounds of appeal related to the crimes for which the accused were convicted. After lunch, the chamber will commence with the session on the grounds of appeal related to Nguyen Chiu's and Kyu Sampon's individual criminal responsibility. We shall conclude this session in the morning of day three of the hearing. Also on Thursday morning, the chamber shall hear submissions in relation to Kyu Sampon's arguments on appeal regarding the sentence imposed by the trial chamber. Thursday afternoon is dedicated to the appeal of the co-prosecutors, and there is time allotted for final questions by the chamber. During this last part of the hearing, the accused may also address the chamber in person. If they so wish, in accordance with Internal Rule 109.5. As to the conduct of the individual sessions, in compliance with the applicable procedural rules, notably Internal Rules 108.5 and 109.4, each session will start with a report of the co-rapporteurs. I appointed the co-rapporteurs for the appeals of Nguyen Chiu, Kyu Sampon, and the co-prosecutors in June of this year to address each aspect of the appeals. Given the size of the appeals and the large number of grounds of appeal, the co-rapporteurs' reports do not attempt to summarize comprehensively and in detail all the submissions on appeal. Rather, they serve as an introduction to the relevant session and as an overview to the general public of the issues raised on appeal. If a particular argument or ground of appeal is not mentioned in the report, this does not mean that the co-rapporteurs have overlooked it. Following the co-rapporteur's remarks, the parties will be invited to make their submissions in the order indicated on the timetable. The parties are instructed not to go beyond the time allotted to them. As we are running on a tight schedule, should it appear that particular aspects of the submissions require more time, the chamber has discretion to afford the parties additional opportunities to supplement their submissions in the time reserved for the judge's questions. This will not be done routinely, but only if strictly required. Finally, in keeping with Internal Rule 109.4, I would like to inform Nguyen Chiu and Kyu Sampon of their fundamental rights under Internal Rule 21D. This provision reads as follows. Every person suspected or prosecuted shall be presumed innocent as long as his or her guilt has not been established. Any such person has the right to be informed of any charges brought against him or her, to be defended by a lawyer of his or her choice, and at every stage of the proceedings, so be informed of his or her right to remain silent.
The
judges at the bench discussed the proceedings, and we decide that the appeal proceedings will proceed despite the absence of the International Council for the accused,
du Conseil international de l'accusé.
And the decision will be made later regarding his absence.
La décision
and I would like now to give the floor to Nguyen Chia to make his statement. And the time allocation to you is not more than 10 minutes. And you may proceed.
Vous avez la parole.
Security personnel, please escort the accused into the dock.
L'avocat national de la défense de Nguyen
Chia.
Brother Sonarum, Mr. President, I'd like to seek your permission that the statement to be read by my client, Nguyen Chia, may take longer than the allotted time, as this is a combined statement, also covering the aspects of the International Council for his defense, and it may run into 20 minutes, and we seek your permission for that.
Atteignant probablement plutôt 20 minutes, c'est pourquoi nous aimerions votre autorisation pour avoir ce temps de parole.
President, the chairman would like to inform
the Defense Counsel for Nguyen Chia, as well as Nguyen Chia himself,
informe le Conseil national de Nguyen Chia ainsi que Nguyen Chia
that the statement to be read by the accused is just part of the introduction of the appeal proceeding, and as indicated by the National Defense Council for Nguyen Chia, he will participate in the proceedings of this appeal hearing. For that reason, please try to make the statement as short as possible per allotted time.
Vous êtes prié de faire au plus bref possible.
My respects to my beloved fellow Cambodians and to all those genuinely committed to truth and justice. I am Nguyen Chia and I was the former Deputy Secretary of the Communist Party of Cambodia. 8 years and 2 months ago, I was arrested and brought before this tribunal. I have been engaged in proceedings here ever since. I thought that this process, if done right, could allow Cambodia, as an innocent, justice-loving nation, to come together and meaningfully discuss what happened during the democratic Cambodia period. It could be our chance, our only chance, to learn the truth from me and from all those who lived through the period. Before we die and take our memories and experiences to the grave forever. I have long recognized that some of my fellow Cambodians suffered during the democratic Cambodia period. As I have said repeatedly, I am remorseful for their suffering and I accept moral responsibility for it. I have engaged with this tribunal because I believed that I have a responsibility to the Cambodian people to help them learn the truth about what really happened in democratic Cambodia, to explain to them, as the surviving leader of the Communist Party of Cambodia, the reasons our party undertook certain actions and what the results were. And I believe that this is what most Cambodians want from this trial as well. However, from day one, it was my strong impression that this tribunal was not at all interested in exploring the truth. Instead, it seems to operate as though its mission was simply to endorse the instructions of a handful of officers in power and tell a tale approved by the government before the tribunal was established. And I was right. In August 2014, after 7 years of proceedings and hundreds of millions of dollars, the trial chamber issued its first trial judgment against me and sentenced me to life imprisonment in case 002/01. The judgment was a shameful failure. It didn't simply fail to deliver truth and justice. It actually managed to take us even further away from the truth and to make a mockery out of justice altogether just in order to prosecute me. My lawyers, in fact, tell me that an academic report was recently released which says the same thing. Despite my lawyers' efforts to encourage a more realistic understanding of events, the trial judgment was extremely oversimplifying and inaccurate. For instance, the trial chamber judges said the Communist Party of Cambodia had a strict hierarchy. They suggested that Pol Pot and I controlled every single Khmer Rouge cadre, from the lowest foot soldier to the highest members of the party's standing and central committees. They ignored evidence that the party was in fact divided internally and that some zones acted autonomously. They ignored evidence that some standing and central committee members, like Sapkham and Ruthnium, had created an opposing faction within the party that tries to overthrow the legitimate government of Democratic Cambodia in a coup organized and instructed by Vietnam. They ignored evidence that all of these events related to Vietnam's long-standing ambition to invade, expand, swallow up Cambodia, and eliminate the Khmer people and integrate Cambodia into an Indo-Chinese federation with Vietnam at the head. My lawyers' attempts to present this evidence were met with skepticism, hostility, and anger. Their microphones were cut off. The judges demonstrated extreme bias against me in the courtroom and in their judgment, ignoring key submissions and evidence put forward by my lawyers. Hiding from the truth as the trial chamber judges did in their judgment serves no one but the Vietnamese. It does nothing to deliver justice and improve understanding. It simply threatens to reduce this whole tribunal to one useless waste of time and effort. As disappointing as the trial judges and investigating judges have been,
la chambre de première instance et les juges d'instruction et
lawyers and I still thought that there could be a chance, however small, that things might be different before
due to
court chamber judges. Accordingly, in consultation with me in December last year, my lawyers submitted to you a 270-page brief in English. It reflected the very poor quality of the trial judgment by appealing it on no less than 223 grounds. Some of those grounds relate to gross violations of my rights to a fair trial by both the trial and investigating judges.
De la chambre de première instance que par les juges d'instruction.
I want to take this opportunity to highlight the most serious violations of them all, the trial chamber's refusal
à savoir le refus de la chambre de première instance
Heng-Samrin as my witness.
Heng-Samrin
was by far the most important witness for the first trial. My lawyers requested him as a witness many times throughout the trial. As a regiment commander and deputy commander of one of the divisions which led the evacuation of Phnom Penh, he is the most important person still alive to have participated in the evacuation. Since he was one of Sao Pem's right-hand men in East Zone military, he could have testified extensively about how the evacuation was to be carried out. I am sure he would have agreed with me that no unnecessary harm was to be inflicted upon the people of Phnom Penh and other cities. He could have confirmed my position that there were never any orders to kill
Lon-Nol
soldiers and officers or to kill innocent people during the evacuation.
Ou encore des innocents pendant l'évacuation.
He could also have testified about his plans to overthrow the government of Democratic Cambodia in a coup by Vietnam. Because he was a senior member of that faction and attended secret meetings in Prey Vang town led by Sao Pem to plan the coup.
Dans la ville de Prey Vang,
indeed,
dirigée par Sao Pim pour préparer ce coup.
When Vietnam cruelly invaded Cambodia,
Heng Samrin
was the person they installed as the new leader of their puppet government. But not only was
Heng
Samrin my most important witness,
Heng Samrin
was also my only character witness.
Était aussi mon seul témoin de personnalité.
I have known Heng Samrin well for over 60 years.
He knows me very well.
He used to be my messenger, and he came with me to meetings with Sao Pem. Sao Pem was like a relative to me. I was very close to Sao Pem. His defection to Vietnam was devastating to me. Heng Samrin could have testified in detail about many things that happened in Democratic Cambodia and about my character. My lawyers told me that they don't know of any court in the world that would ever refuse to hear a character witness. Despite all of these reasons, every single Cambodian judge in the trial chamber refused to call Heng Samrin as a witness, just like all the Cambodian judges and prosecutors before them. They said that trying to summon Heng Samrin, who is the president of the National Assembly, could lead to many problems, and they weren't prepared to take this risk. They admitted that these problems would undermine the trial chamber's position. In doing so, the national judges admitted that this tribunal is powerless. It is disrespected and is simply acting under the pressure of the government. And international judges are no better, for although they agreed that Heng Samrin should have been called, they refused to consider what the effect of his evidence would have been on their judgment. Why are the international judges even here then? Because of the decision not to call Heng Samrin, and because of the poor quality of the judgment, I discussed with my lawyers to seek the disqualification of the trial chamber from the second trial against me.
De première instance pour le deuxième procès à mon
My lawyers accused that it was clear,
les avocats ont soutenu qu'il était clair
that
que
the judges were biased and could not bring an open mind to the second trial against me. Of course, this motion was dismissed, although one international judge said he would have agreed with us. We were forced to press ahead in the second trial with the same judges and the same unfair procedures in place. It has now been nearly a year since we started hearings in the second trial, and it has proved to be at least as frustrating, biased, and unfair as the first trial,
maybe even more so.
The situation has in fact become so bad that 3 months ago, my lawyers walked out of proceedings in response to the latest injustice. As I explained, my lawyers could no longer take what was happening in this courtroom. The injustice that day was one of many,
une injustice parmi tant d'autres,
and too much for them to bear,
et ce fut trop à supporter pour mes avocats.
Especially knowing that there would be more and more injustices coming in the future. And while my lawyers have done their best to press on and continue with the trial, every day they face more injustices. At the same time as participating in the second trial, my lawyers have also been very active with the Supreme Court chamber. In consultation with me, they have filed many requests to admit new evidence when this new evidence has come to light. This new evidence, more than ever before, provides insight into the head and tail of the crocodile, and not just the crocodile's body. The evidence confirms that Vietnam attempted a coup d'état during the Democratic Cambodia period. According to the filmmakers Ted Sambat and Robert Lemkin, already in May 1975, Sarpem and Ruthnium held a meeting in Phnom Penh. With some other zone leaders, they agreed to try to destabilize and overthrow the government of Democratic Cambodia. Their plans included assassination attempts against Pol Pot, stocks of weapons, uniforms, food, and other supplies were gathered. Meetings were held. False propaganda was spread. Many people were starving because of their plans. Two coup attempts took place in 1976. Namely, an explosion in Siem Reap in February and an attack outside the Royal Palace in April. According to the evidence, these plans were part of a much grander scheme of Vietnam, which began in 1977 and involved several zones around the country, which would crush our government militarily. The new evidence now clearly tells us that if this rebellion would not succeed, Vietnam would invade Cambodia directly, and as we all know, that is what they finally did, using over 100,000 soldiers and some tanks. In the beginning, my lawyers and I were encouraged by the Supreme Court Chamber's response to the evidence request. It seemed as if it was the first time at this tribunal that judges, including Cambodian judges, were willing to come to discuss with an open mind. to engage in a real discussion about the issues. My lawyers were particularly encouraged by the Chamber's agreement to open an investigation into evidence that was collected by the filmmakers Pete Sambat and Rob Lemkin. They were also further encouraged when the Chamber scheduled testimony of three witnesses we had asked to testify on appeal. In light of all of these developments, my lawyers had been preparing for and carefully and patiently awaiting these appeal hearings. Their disappointment was immense, therefore, when the Chamber announced that not one of the witnesses we requested would be called to testify on appeal. None. Not Heinz Samrin, not Rob Lemkin, not Tate Sambat. My lawyers had thought that the Chamber would at least call Heinz Samrin, that what he has to say is obviously incredibly important, but they were wrong. In the end, you decided in the same way as all the judges before you. How disappointing. That Supreme Court Chamber decision also dismissed all our new evidence and offered no reasons at all, making it impossible to understand. Your Honours, because of your decision, the outcome of the appeal is now irrelevant to me. It has become clear to me that the Supreme Court Chamber is just as biased, unwilling, and as afraid as those that have come before you to really explore what the truth worth. You refuse to give me even just the chance to tell the Cambodian people my side of the story. Your decision has confirmed that my assessment of this tribunal has always been right, as the court would serve only those who it belongs to. It is nothing but a meaningless effort designed just to convict me. Accordingly, following a discussion with me, my international lawyer, Victor Copper, is not participating in these hearings. I will also leave these proceedings once I have finished making my comments, and I would also like to instruct my national lawyer, Mr. Son Arun, not to participate in these proceedings any further and not to respond to any kind of questions by the judges or their other parties. We choose instead to rest on the arguments made in my appeal brief. However, I have stopped short of withdrawing my appeal altogether in honor of the responsibility I continue to feel to have the Cambodian understand the truth of what really happened in the democratic Cambodia period. I urge you, judges, to have courage to consider your commitment to truth and justice when writing your judgment. The Cambodian nation,
la nation cambodgienne,
which has clear and delight knowledge, is waiting for you to deliver truth and justice in your
judgment.
Cambodia will never have this opportunity again. Thank you.
Merci.
Chứng tam sẽ đầy thay cả.
President,
le président.
After hearing the statement of the
Après
accused,
avoir entendu la déclaration de l'accusé,
not intended to be here in the courtroom, is that correct?
Avez-vous donc l'intention de vous retirer du prétoire?
And another matter is about the co-counsel, the national co-counsel for Mr. Nguyen
Chi. Are
you willing to participate in the courtroom?
Ou êtes-vous prêt à rester au prétoire?
Mr. President,
as Monsieur le Président,
stated in the statement of the accused,
comme l'a indiqué l'accusé dans sa déclaration,
me not to participate in the
mon client m'a demandé de ne
today.
Pas participer à l'audience en appel aujourd'hui.
President, so
le Président,
it means that you will
cela
not
signifie
be participating
donc que vous ne participerez pas à ces audiences.
From the accused, he stated that you will be
d'après
here, but not respond
avoir
to
que
any
vous
question or any comments.
Sans répondre à des questions ni formuler des
commentaires.
Sonarun,
in the statement of Mr. Nguyen Chi,
dans la déclaration,
he instructed me to
Nguyen-Chia,
leave the courtroom.
Il m'a donné l'instruction de quitter le prétoire.
After the break.
Après la pause.
He instructs Sonarun, the defense counsel, not to respond
il
any question or comments, and also not to participate in the appeal hearing after the break.
Ne pas répondre à des questions,
I think
de
it is clear enough from the statement of the accused.
Je pense que la déclaration de l'accusé est claire.
Counsel, this chamber's considered opinion that it is not for the accused to decide whether you stay or not in the courtroom. It is only the chamber that can dismiss you upon such an application. Meanwhile,
une fois que vous en aurez formulé la demande,
it is obligatory that the accused have a counsel. And as such, the counsel needs to stay in the courtroom. As to the presence of the accused, we may discuss whether we consider it obligatory or not. You may want to consult Internal Rule 22.4, Article 301 of the Cambodian Code of Criminal Procedure, and Article 7 of the Administrative Regulation of the DSS that are binding upon you. Thank you. I think it will serve this appellate hearing if the parties kindly follow the order of the proceedings as announced by Mr. President, which commences with the report of the rapporteurs on the part that we will be discussing today, following which the parties are invited to furnish any comments they may wish to make.
President,
le président,
I would like to clarify the matter with you, counsel. A while ago,
donc,
the
maître,
accused
que
stated that he will not be present in the courtroom, and as clearly stated by Judge Millard,
comme vient de
the
nous le dire, la juge
counsel is required to be in the courtroom in accordance with Article 301 of the Cambodian Criminal Code of Procedure. I understand that there is an instruction from your client, but you are obliged to be here in the courtroom in accordance with Article 301 of the Cambodian Criminal Code, Procedural Code. So now I want to make it clear with you. You will be here in the courtroom,
vous
or
allez bien
you will
rester au prétoire,
leave the
vous
courtroom
avez l'intention
as well.
De quitter le prétoire, maître.
Sonarun, thank you, Mr. President.
Merci,
I
Monsieur
would like
le
to inform Your Honours that we are professional I am a professional lawyer. I must respect all existing laws.
And
let me make it clear that I duly respect this chamber. However, I am required to listen to the instruction of my client.
If not,
my client will dismiss me.
Sans quoi,
therefore, I shall and must listen to the instruction of my client.
Donc d'écouter et de suivre les instructions de mon client.
Thank you.
Mr. President,
allow me to make a comment here.
Puis-je prendre la parole?
President.
Le président.
Please all be seated.
Veuillez vous asseoir.
This means that you will recuse.
Vous souhaitez donc vous recuser.
You will accuse and you will leave the courtroom.
So it is vous souhaitez donc
a
suivre les
matter
instructions
for
de
you to decide.
Et,
as Judge Malat and I
donc,
informed you already, you
décider,
are obliged to
present
in the courtroom in a felony case. So it is a matter of the decision by the Supreme Court chamber in this case.
Donc,
so now,
ici,
once again, I will give you another
suprême,
chance
vous êtes obligé de rester
to clarify the
encore,
matter.
L'occasion de préciser vos intentions.
In accordance with Article 28 of the statute,
en application de l'article
28, we will rely on our conscience
statute,
and we will also need to listen to the instruction of clients
nos convictions
for the interests
et
of
les instructions
the client.
Du client dans l'intérêt de mon client.
On behalf of the chamber, I am warning you that if you leave the courtroom, you will be in contempt of court, and we will be drawing consequences of it. This chamber does not allow you to leave. I also want to inform you that this is crystal clear for this chamber, that this appears like a tactics aimed at obstacling the proceedings. It's been used in other international tribunals unsuccessfully, and we have citations from cases where international criminal tribunals did not allow such a walkout, even upon instruction from the client. This is our final position on this matter. I suggest the hearing continues.
Je propose de poursuivre l'audience.
Son Aaron.
Maître Son Aaron.
Judge Millard, I heard
Madame la juge,
you mentioned about the instruction of the
vous avez
chamber. But I must comply with the
chambre,
statute of the Bar Association of the Kingdom of Cambodia, Article 58. Lawyers will have to rely on our conscience and will have to comply with the instruction of one's client. So I will need time to consult with my clients because I am representing my clients. I understand, I respect the chamber. However, I have to listen and respect my client as well. And it is very clear from the statute of the Bar Association of the Kingdom of Cambodia.
De l'association de l'ordre du barreau du Royaume du Cambodge
lawyers
est très clair à cet égard.
Needs to receive agreement of the client
les avocats
whom the lawyer is representing.
Avoir l'accord
so I humbly request your honors to consider the statutes of the Bar Association of the Kingdom of Cambodia.
Du règlement de l'ordre du barreau
it, and it is my obligation to comply with that
j'ai
statute as well. Thank you,
de respecter
your honors.
Ce règlement. Merci. Monsieur les juges.
President, you have the floor now, International
le
Co-Prosecutor.
Your Honor, we would like to be heard on the issue of Nunchia attending these proceedings. These proceedings, as everyone knows, are extremely serious, dealing with some of the most serious crimes imaginable. He's being here not because of an invitation to something like a cocktail party that you can decline to attend. He's here because he's facing extremely serious charges that involve suffering and victims from around Cambodia. It's also not his role in these proceedings to decide how they will be run. That, of course, is up to your honors. Counsel also cannot take instructions to do things that are against the rules of the court. Under the way counsel is interpreting his bar association rules, a lawyer would have to follow the instructions of his client to insult witnesses or judges to disclose confidential information that could endanger witnesses because it's his client's instructions. That, of course, is not the law anywhere. Counsel are here to vigorously defend their clients as they've done throughout the trial and the appeal, but they're not here to obstruct the proceedings. We urge you to require Nunchia to be here for the majority of these proceedings, absent a medical reason for him not to be present. And thank you for listening.
Qu'il ne le soit pas, je vous remercie.
President, you have the floor now.
Le président, maître Salomon,
thank you very much.
Vous avez la parole, comme Salomon.
Good morning, Monsieur le Président. Your honors, everyone in and around
Madame,
the courtroom. Let me voice my intervention on the matter which has just arisen out of this in the course of proceeding. I have listened attentively to Judge Millard, and from my understanding, it is a threat to the profession of a lawyer.
Ce que j'entends,
Mr. Sonaron made it clear already in his position that he receives an instruction from his client to walk out or leave the courtroom, and he is also instructed not to respond to any question or comments before the chamber. So it is clear and sufficiently lawyer can make a decision to walk out and leave the courtroom.
L'avocat
and if the court considers that the walkout is
si
a contempt of the court, I believe it is threatened by the chamber here. Lawyers enjoy freedom of profession.
Au métier d'avocat. Les avocats doivent être libres d'exercer leur métier.
Mr. President mentioned Article 301 of the Cambodian Criminal Procedural Code. I understand that we need to comply with that article. However, it is not an absolute article that we lawyers need to comply with.
And
the chamber can't find another lawyer to represent a client if it thinks a fit. So we have to consider
every point, d'autres avocats
every point
pour
here. So the defense counsel here are selected by the clients. They are not appointed by the chamber and specifically the Supreme Court chamber.
Par la chambre et surtout pas par la chambre de la Cour suprême.
And I understand that the lawyers are appointed by the courts sometimes have to respect with the instruction of the courtroom, but here
it
is a different case. We are representing the client. We need to follow the instruction of the client. This matter arose before the trial chamber a few months ago, so it's the same case here. Thank you very much.
Dans ce même dossier, il y a quelques mois. Je vous remercie.
Sommes-chien.
You have the floor now, international lead co-lawyer.
Le président, co-avocat principal, vous avez la parole.
Look, you just have to put all the cash out of the hat me to be no more. My two great client.
I will first give the floor to international lead co-lawyer.
Je donne d'abord la parole au co-avocat principal international.
Merci, Monsieur le Président,
you,
et bonjour à tous. Nous avons juste une courte
simple,
observation liée à la présence de Nunchia dans cette salle d'audience. Nunchia a été convoquée et nous avons expliqué à plusieurs reprises à quel point la présence physique de l'accusé dans la salle d'audience est importante. La règle 81 du règlement intérieur intime à l'accusé d'être présent. Donc de deux choses l'une, soit Nunchia dépose une dispense pour raison médicale et il peut dès lors quitter cette salle d'audience, soit il ne dépose pas comme il le fait habituellement devant la chambre de première instance une dispense pour des motifs médicaux précis et dès lors, sa présence dans la salle d'audience est requise et obligatoire au regard des règles et du règlement intérieur de ce tribunal.
President, you have the floor now, Mr. Accused.
Le président, l'accusé, vous avez la parole.
Counsel Sonarun, Mr. President, my client is unwell and he requests to take a rest.
Président, mon client est souffrant.
He signaled to the bench to seek your permission to rest as he can no longer sit in the courtroom due to his poor health.
D'aller se reposer. Il ne peut plus rester au prétoire en raison de son état de santé.
President.
Le président.
The bench has discussed the problem before us, the internal rules and the Cambodian law specifies the absolute presence of the accused during the hearing, except in the case of a poor health, for instance,
sauf en cas de mauvaise santé, par exemple.
A medical report informing the chamber that he can no longer be present in the courtroom due to health condition, then he may be granted to follow the proceedings from the holding cell downstairs.
Il pourra avoir l'autorisation de suivre la procédure depuis
And indeed, we do have a copy of the medical report dated 17 November 2015, which specifies that he has severe backache and that he can not sit in a courtroom.
Nunchia souffre de maux de dos et ne peut pas rester assis au prétoire.
And based on this medical report, the accused is granted to follow the proceedings from the holding cell downstairs, and security personnel
are
instructed to take the accused Nunchia to the room downstairs, and the AV unit is instructed to link the proceedings to the room downstairs so that the accused can follow it.
Vérifier que l'accusé est en mesure de suivre la procédure par des moyens audiovisuels.
And I notice the national co-prosecutor on her feet. You may proceed.
Le co-procureur national, vous avez la parole.
Chilien, good morning,
Maître
Mr. Chilien, President,
bonjour,
Your Honours, and good morning, everyone in and around the courtroom.
Bonjour à tous.
It is my understanding that before the chamber is granted to follow the proceedings from the room downstairs, I have two questions that I would like to put to the chamber. However, the chamber has already made its decision to allow him to follow the proceedings from the room downstairs. I'd like to clarify on the waiver of his right to participate in the hearing. And second, in relation to his appeal hearing, he already made his statement, but I want to know for certain whether he still maintains his appeal, against the judgment.
Contre le jugement
and of course, the international lead co-lawyer for civil parties rightly said so that it is important to have the presence of the accused during the hearing against him. And I urge that the chamber has to make clear on this issue, although you decide already to have the accused follow the proceedings remotely.
I'd like to give the floor to Judge Millard.
This chamber's opinion, the accused stated very clearly that he stopped short of withdrawing the appeal, meaning he did not withdraw an appeal, although certain representations had the effect of declaring his passive attitude during the appellate proceedings. Meanwhile, as you noticed, we already ruled that he can go follow the proceedings from downstairs upon the medical report, which we have no grounds to question. Now I am told by the President that we should move on.
Le président me dit donc qu'il est temps d'avancer.
President, allow me to add to this matter. Regarding the National Council for the Defense, the bench deliberated the issue,
de la défense de Nunchia,
and in our view, that the National Defense Council needs to follow the instructions of his client, and it is expressly clear that he is banned or prohibited per instructions of his client to respond
or
to make any statement during this appeal hearing. Despite all that, the National Defense Council must be present in the courtroom during the appeal hearing, and it is your right whether you wish to respond or to make any statement or otherwise.
Vous avez le droit de choisir de répondre ou non et de faire des déclarations ou non pendant la procédure.
President, National Defense Council, you may be seated.
Le président, l'avocat national, veuillez vous asseoir.
Do you wish to make any other points, Defense
Est-ce
Council?
Est-ce que vous avez autre chose à dire?
In fact, the chamber has ruled that you must be present in the courtroom, and whether you wish to exercise your rights to respond to any issues raised during the appeal proceeding, or you wish to respect the instructions of your client. However, your presence is required in the courtroom. And I'd like to invite the co-rapporteurs to read the report for the sessions on the ground of appeals relating to fairness of proceedings and constitutionality of the internal rules
et la constitutionnalité du règlement intérieur.
Judge Momonikaya, thank you, Mr. President. And on behalf of the co-rapporteurs, myself and Judge Nihal Yasinghe, I'd like to read the co-rapporteur's report in relation to the grounds of appeals relating to fairness of proceedings and constitutionality of the internal rules. Nunchi and Kyo Sampon submit that in the course of the proceedings before the trial chamber, there were various violations of their rights to a fair trial. Their arguments fall into four broad categories. First, they submit that their rights to an independent tribunal was violated. They submit that the trial chamber was deeply biased against them and incapable of impartially assessing the evidence. The lack of independence and impartiality was, in their submission, evidenced by the fact that the trial chamber did not call certain witnesses. The defense for Nunchi had requested to appear,
à des charges demandées par la défense
notably
de
Nunchia,
notamment Heng Samrin.
Reference is also made to statements of Judge
Ils
Cartwright,
font également référence à des déclarations de la
who
juge
was
Cartwright,
one of the judges of the trial chamber at a conference
instance,
which, in the submissions of the defense, disclosed bias as well as alleged general shortcomings of the Cambodian judiciary.
Second,
Nunchi and Kyo Sampon raised a number of arguments alleging that their rights to an effective defense has been violated. In that regard, they submit, inter alia, that the trial chamber did not give sufficient time to the defense, did not give an opportunity to fully question certain witnesses, and failed to call key defense witnesses, notably Heng Samrin, Uk Bun Chun, and Robert Lemkin. The appellants also challenged the procedure regarding the admission of documentary evidence and certain procedural orders of the trial chamber. Third, Nunchi and Kyo Sampon argue that the trial chamber failed to provide proper and comprehensive reasons for key decisions taken in the course of the proceedings. It is also argued that the trial chamber itself is insufficiently reasoned as it failed to address key defense arguments raised before the trial chamber.
Fourth,
Nunchi and Kyo Sampon raised several arguments that relate to their rights to be informed of the charges against them. Some of these arguments also challenge the scope of the trial in case 002/01, as the appellants argue that 1. Throughout the proceedings, it was not clear which charges were actually encompassed by the trial, and 2. The trial chamber relied on fact that were actually outside the scope of the trial, and the trial chamber erred when relying on those facts. In addition, Nunchi submits that the ECCC's internal rules are unconstitutional and illegal. He submits that under the applicable law, the judges of the ECCC did not have the power to adopt internal rules, and that this amounted to a breach of the Cambodian constitution. He underlines further that in accordance with the ECCC agreement, there can only be recourse to procedural rules established at the international level if there is a lacuna in Cambodian law. In other words, if there is an uncertainty about the interpretation of the applicable law or a question about its compatibility with international standards, He notes that many of the internal rules provide for fewer rights for the defense than the Cambodian Code of Criminal Procedure. This is a summary of the co-rapporteur's report. Thank you. President, thank you. And in accordance with the timetable, it will be now the time given to the parties. And first, I would like to give the floor to the defense for Nguyen Chia.
Le moment est venu de donner la parole aux parties. Je donne en premier lieu la parole à la défense de Nguyen Chia.
Sonaron,
my name is Sonaron. I am a defense counsel for Nguyen Chia.
Je suis au Conseil national de Nguyen Chia.
My oral submission today has already been included in the statement read out by my client. For that reason, I do not have any further to add or to respond to any question by other parties. President, please be reminded that this appeal hearing is the last chance for you to make your oral response to in relation to your appeal against the judgment in case 002-01, and you just confirmed that your statement or your response or oral submission is already encompassed in your client's statement. But be clear that this first session is in relation to your appeal on the issues of the constitutionality of the internal rules. And if you decide not to make any oral submission, the court still proceed with its own timetable. And based on your confirmation, you may be seated. And we will take a 20-minute break from now. And when we return, the floor will be given to another party.